In a previous video, we discussed what a normal distribution is. Real quick, it's a graph or a curve above the x-axis that is symmetrical about the mean. So if we draw a line right down the middle, representing the mean, both sides are equal in shape and area under the curve. The biggest thing to understand is that the space under the curve is an area, and this area actually represents the probability, and this area is equal to 1. The standard normal distribution makes two modifications. The mean is 0, and the standard deviation is 1. The reason this is important is that it allows us to use z-scores, and z-scores are measures of position that tell us the number of standard deviation a value is from the mean. For instance, if we had a z-score of 2.13, that would be this line here on our standard normal distribution graph. So it is 2.13 units, or standard deviations, from the mean. Z-scores are important because they make it much easier to calculate areas, which are probabilities. The formula for a z-score is z equals a value minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. And statistically, it's written as z equals x minus mu divided by sigma. Let's take a look at an example of how to use this formula to calculate a z-score and how to use that z-score to calculate probability. So let's say that you gathered some data for a year for your commuting time to work. The average time was 44 minutes with a standard deviation of 3.5. And we're going to assume the data is normally distributed. Graphing this, we have the mean of 44 here in the middle. If we add one standard deviation to the mean, we get 47.5 here. And adding two standard deviations, we get 51 here. Subtracting one standard deviation from the mean, we get 40.5 here. And subtracting two standard deviations from the mean, we get 37 here. Now let's say we want to know the probability that it takes you less than 40 minutes to get to work tomorrow. 40 on the graph is about here. So it lies between negative 1 and negative 2 standard deviations from the mean. As I stated earlier, the space under this curve represents an area or probability. So if we can calculate the area from less than 40 minutes to the left of the line, that will be the probability that you get to work in less than 40 minutes. This is where z-scores come in. So first we're going to convert the 40, in this case our x value, into a z-score. Using the formula, we have z equals 40 minus 44, the mean, divided by 3.5, the standard deviation, which equals negative 1.14. Now we can graph this on the standard normal distribution curve like this. And with this z-score of negative 1.14, we can use a standard normal distribution z-score table to look up the area or probability. You can find this table through an internet search or in any statistics book. So we find negative 1.1 in the left column and go over 5 columns to the right under 0.04. which is negative 1.14, and the value equals 0.1271. This value is the area to the left of the line, or the probability. If our z-score was negative 1.18, we would go over here to the 0.08 column, which is 0.1190. And looking at the standard normal curve, with both negative 1.14 and negative 1.18 marked, negative 1.18 has a smaller area to the left. That's why its value is smaller in the table. This is the table for negative z-scores, and there is also a table for positive z-scores as you see here, and we'll use this later in the video. For our question, we would answer there is a 12.71% probability that it takes less than 40 minutes to get to work tomorrow. A couple of notes. When we write this probability, we write it as probability of x less than 40. We don't use less than or equals to. The reason for this is that for a continuous variable, the probability of an exact value is 0, as vertical lines, in theory, have no area. So if we wanted to find the probability of between 45 to 50 minutes, we would write that as probability of 45 less than x less than 50. Or we could have the probability of x greater than 48. The second thing is that the values in the standard normal distribution z-score table give the area to the left of the z-score. Even the table for positive z-scores gives you the area to the left. Using the standard normal distribution and z-scores, we have calculated the area or probability of something lower than, or to the left of a z-score. And there are two other important ways to use this method. For finding the area or probability of something between two values, or finding the area or probability of something greater than a value. First, let's look at between two values. What is the probability that it takes you between 38 and 45 minutes to get to work? On the normal distribution graph, we're looking for this area here. So we have probability of 38 less than x less than 45. First, we need to convert 38 and 45 to z-scores. Using our formula, we have 38 minus 44, the mean, divided by 3.5, the the standard deviation, which equals negative 1.71. And 45 minus 44 divided by 3.5 equals 0.29. Now we need to look up these z-scores in the table. For negative 1.71, we have 0.0436. And for z equals 0.29, the table shows 0.6141. Let's look at this on the standard normal graph. So we have the area to the left of negative 1.71 equals 0.0436. And the area to the left of 0.29 is 0.6141. And we need to find the area between these two z-scores. To find this, we subtract the area to the left of z equals negative 1.71 from the area of z equals 0.29. So 0.6141 minus 0.0436 equals 0.5705. And that is our probability. Now we can say that the probability it takes you between 38 and 45 minutes to get to work is 57.05%. The last way we can use the standard normal distribution and z-scores is to find the probability of something greater than a value. Let's stick with the last example. What is the probability that it takes you longer than 45 minutes to get to work? On the normal distribution graph, we're looking for this area here to the right of the line. From our last problem, we know the z-score for 45 minutes is 0.29. And from the table, we know that the area to the left is 0.6141 on the standard normal graph. Since we know the entire area under the curve is equal to 1, we can subtract the area to the left of z equals 0.29 from 1 to get the area on the right. So 1 minus 0.6141 equals 0.3859, which is our probability. So there's a 38.59% probability that it takes you longer than 45 minutes to get to work. All right, my friends, that be the basics on the standard normal distribution. Hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.